Hi, this is Christopher Boucher, and I'm going to review a chi-square goodness of fit test. And in this one, we're going to use the Poisson distribution, which for certain reasons, it could be a little bit more difficult. It's at least more difficult than basic dice examples. Okay, we'll get started. The question says, perform a chi-square goodness of fit test to determine if the data below appears to follow a Poisson probability distribution with a lambda of 1.25 at a 5% level of significance. So these are our values right here. These are our observed of the values right here. So there's all the information. Okay, now down below I made up this table that's partially filled in to make it easy on us. Okay. And these are the values. Notice right here, this says 3+. So that's 3 and everything above. Okay. So the most difficult part about this is the finding the probability for the Poisson distribution. And it's a little bit of a task in itself because you have to remember how to do this part of it and then go and apply it to the chi-square. So that's kind of the issue. The other thing is we have 3+ here, which means we have to find the probability for the 3 and everything else above it. Now, it's not that difficult, but usually by the time that you start doing the chi-square, the Poisson distribution was a little while ago, so you have to kind of remember how to do that. Okay, so let's take a look at the first one. We have, we're looking for the value of 0, and we want to find the probability of that. And I'm going to do it on the calculator only because it is easier and much quicker than doing the full calculation by hand. So I'm going to pull over the calculator, TI-83-84 variant. I'll put it on this side of the screen. Turn it on. Clear. Okay, we have to go into second, and then the DIST TR. Area right there, and we'll go down, and it is the Poisson. Now in this case, you can do it different ways, but in this case we're just looking for the PDF. Okay, that'll just give us that one value. There's different ways to do this, of course, but we need a value for each one, so we're gonna use the Poisson PDF. So we're gonna put in here 1.25, enter, and then the value of 0, enter, paste, and we get the probability of getting the 0 is 0.2865. And then I'm going to, instead of going back into the front end of the menu each time, I go up and then hit enter, and it pulls it down for me. So now I'm going to go over, and I'm just going to change the 0 to a 1, and go back out, hit enter, and it will do 0.3581. Okay, and then number 2, I can just do the same thing. And I get 0.22. Okay. So this last one has to be a little bit different for us just because of the way it's made up. It's at 3+. There's a couple ways to do it, and the easiest way is just what you want to do is add these three up and then subtract it from 1, because probability can only be 0 to 1, so we know it's bounded by the upper limit of 1. So if we add these all up, we can do it real quick. 0.2865 plus 0.3581 plus 0.2238. What do we get? Now I could copy what I have there on the calculator, but it actually will give me a slightly different answer because it's more precise. Because I cut off some of the decimal places, so I'm just going to use what I wrote down. 0.3581 plus 0.2238. Okay, so I get this. I'm going to draw one there and then subtract. I get 0.86. Move my mouse. 84. And if I take this and subtract our answer from 1, then I will get everything else. And everything else is 0.1316. And that is our 3 plus value. So that's probably the easiest way to find that value. Okay, now we're going to put the calculator away for now. So we did all the Poisson probability part, which is kind of the tricky part. If you haven't just studied the Poisson, you have to remember how it works. Okay, so the expected, we're going to fill these in. The expected, what you do is you take the probability multiplied by the total. And the total for this problem, the total is 100. So if we multiply these by 100, this is another one where it makes the numbers kind of nice. You end up with 28.6. You just have to move the decimal point. So 35.81 and then 22.38 and 13.16. Okay. And then we subtract observed from expected. And I'll write these in. We get -13.65, 1.19, 1.84. Okay, so it's -13.65, 1.19, 10.62, and 1.84. Okay, and then we just square that. And remember, with negatives, make sure you put parentheses around it, because otherwise the calculator doesn't always do it right, which is amazing in my opinion. But it's a really, really equipped calculator, but sometimes it doesn't do it right. Okay, so our answer is, when we square this, 186,322, say. Okay, 1.416, 112.784, and 3.385. Okay, and then the last one, we take this squared value and we divide it by the expected, and we end up with 6.503. .039, and then 5.039, and then 0.257. Okay, then we want to add these all up, and when we add these up, we end up with 11.838. So this is our calculated statistic for this. And one other thing that I've brought up in other videos, when you add, there's a couple ways to check on your columns. Remember, I said that if this equals 100, of course, this should equal 100. I just brought it down. But this should, of course, equal 100. And this should equal 1. And this should equal 100 as well. Okay? So you can make sure that these columns are, that you haven't made a mistake. Because if you make a mistake in these, then put them in the calculator, you'll just be confirming your mistake. Okay, so we have our expected our calculated values, so that's great. Now we're going to find find what our critical value is. And the critical value, first of all, we have degrees of freedom, DF. So it always is DF minus one. So categories minus one. Now there's one other thing though, minus one. And when we are working with estimated parameters, at times we will subtract the number of estimated parameters, or any time really. And with some Poisson problems, you subtract the Poisson lambda as a estimated parameter, and with some of them you don't. In this one, we don't. And the reason is it's given, and it is as if this is a population figure. It is technically the Poisson probability in this case is a stated mean, like same type of thing as a population mean, which makes it a not a estimated statistic, but it makes it as if it is a population value. So, which means it's good as gold. Now, if this was a calculated lambda, which there are problems that I've made that you have to actually create the lambda out of the sample data. And if you do that, then it is considered an estimated parameter and also known as an M, and you would subtract that. But in this case, we're given lambda as if it is a population value, so we don't subtract it. So we're not going to subtract it this time. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So four categories, minus one. So 4 minus 1. So we have 3 for degrees of freedom. So our chi-square, we have 3 degrees of freedom. And then we're looking for 0.05. So let's see what our calculated, our critical value is going to be. Our critical value was degrees of freedom 3.05. I'll zoom in. So we have 3.05, 7.815. Let's zoom back. Okay, so we're going to place this as the cutoff for our rejection zone. Now, this value, our calculated value in this case, is greater than our critical value. So, it is inside of our rejection zone, and whenever it's inside of the rejection zone, it means we reject HO, which means this problem, in this problem, it does not appear to follow the Poisson probability distribution with a lambda of 1.25 at a 5% level of significance. Okay? Thank you for watching.